Welcome to the GO system, your new GPS fleet management solution. Here we will discuss the setup and initial configuration of your new account. Your new GO devices begin reporting within minutes of installation into the vehicle. Billing begins 14 days after shipment. Devices should be installed in their respective vehicles prior to configuring the online account. This allows for complete configuration of the system in a single sitting. The first step in configuration is to log into your account with the username and password emailed the day your order shipped. If the email isn't available, contact our support department at 877-467-0326 to obtain your new username and password. Once credentials are available, go to http://www.fleetistics.com, then click the login link. Enter your credentials to complete the login process. The initial homepage is My Fleetistics. This is the initial point of entry into your online fleet management portal. My Fleetistics provides a set of tools to supplement those offered through the GO system. Take a few minutes to explore the options available. To proceed, click the My Geotab button located in the main menu on the left. Once clicked, you are presented with the dashboard. The first step in configuration is to set the user options. This is accomplished by clicking your username located in the upper right corner and selecting Options from the menu. Select the desired measurement system from the menu. By default, the system is set to metric. Next, select the date format used on reports and on screen. Select a time format. Specify your time zone. By default, it is set to Eastern Time. Once all settings are made, scroll to the top of the window and click the Save button. Now that your user options are specified, we need to set up groups. Groups are used in and by different aspects of the system. First, groups are used to organize vehicles, users, zones, and rules. Secondly, they are used to isolate information from users that shouldn't have access. For example, groups can be used to provide access to information for a specific department and restrict viewing of information associated with other departments. For more information on group structures, click Getting Started and Help, Geotab Guide, then click the Groups link. This document provides guidance on developing the structure of your groups. To create a group, navigate to Rules and Groups, Groups. By default, a single group named Entire Organization begins your group tree. To create the first group, click the plus sign to the right of the Entire Organization group and a new window is displayed. Here we enter the name and any type of description that assists others in understanding the items contained in the group. Next, we choose a color. The color selected here is used to display group members on the live map and to mark trips on the trip history window. Once all entries are made, click the Save button located near the top of the window. Repeat these steps to create additional groups. Now that our groups are created, we can edit our device names and assign them to a group. Open the Vehicles window by clicking Vehicles in the left menu. By default, the names are the serial numbers of the GO devices. Open a Vehicle Details window by clicking the name. Enter a name for the vehicle in the description field. Do not be concerned about entering the VIN or odometer reading. These fields are populated by the device reports. Now click the Groups tab and select the group or groups the vehicle is to be a member of. Keep in mind, a vehicle can be a member of multiple groups. Once all entries are made, click the Save button. Initially, your new account contains two users. One is support at fleetistics.com. This user allows us access for support and maintenance. The second is the user cited in your introductory email. To create new users, go to Administration, Users, and click the Add button located near the top of the window. Enter an email address, first and last name, password, and password confirmation in the fields provided. If the assigned password is temporary and the user should be forced to enter a new one at first login, enable the Force Password option. Then specify a security clearance. Once all entries and selections are made, click the Save button. Zones are used to define geographic regions so the system can provide notifications when a vehicle enters, exits, operates within, or stops inside of a zone. Zones can be used to define customer locations, homes, regions, or delivery areas. To create a zone, click Map and locate the area to include by using the search field to enter an address or zooming and dragging inside the map until you see the area. Changing to satellite view can assist in viewing the area details. To begin, click and release the mouse button, reposition the mouse, click and release again. Repeat these steps until the area to include is surrounded by the black line. To finish, click and release the mouse button on the beginning point, and a new window is displayed containing the options for the zone. Enter a name. The name should be self-identifying since it appears on reports and on the map. The new zone can be restricted to specific groups by selecting a group name from the menu. Once all entries and selections are made, click the Save button located near the top of the window. Let's take a few minutes for intermission. Click the Stop button in your viewer. During this time, log into your account and try the new knowledge you have gained. When finished, come back here and click the Play button. Exception rules, or just rules, are used to define behaviors or conditions to track within the system. For example, a rule can be created that identifies when a vehicle's speed exceeds a certain level. Once the level is reached, the system can either log the exception to appear on a report, or in more urgent situations, an email notification can be sent to a designated recipient. The system includes two types of rules, standard and custom. Standard rules include speeding, harsh braking, hard acceleration, and harsh cornering, to name a few. Custom reports can include specific situations such as a vehicle entering or exiting a zone. Here we will discuss the standard rules. For more information on custom rules, see our Creating Custom Rules video. To access standard rules, click Rules and Groups, Rules, in the left menu. In this example, we enable the speeding rule. To enable this rule, click the On button. Then to specify how far over the speed limit before an exception is logged by the system, use either the slider or enter a number in the field provided. To enable notifications, click the email icon. To add an email address to send notification, click the Add Email button and make a selection from the list provided, or enter an email address in the field, then click the Add button. Once all entries or selections are made, click the Save button. The live map provides visual location of vehicles, zones, groups, traffic, and rule exceptions. To display current locations of vehicles, click Map, then select the vehicles to display by making selections from this menu. Trips History allows for displaying a breadcrumb trail illustrating the route a vehicle has taken. To display a trip on the map, select the vehicles to include from the vehicle menu. Then click the Trips History button and a list of trips is displayed.